toy hunters, the source of vintage and modern collectible toys. Let's see what they have inside, shall we? Major fans. Zero, Money Morphin, classic stuff like that. There's some anime, Gundam. Robotech, aka Mockers. That's not a bad price. They play music. Might as well then play music to keep the atmosphere of this place not so boring or whatever. Power Rangers Titan. This is the classic box right here. Look at this thing. Hi.
How's it going?
It's going fine, thank you. Here's the toy's version. Sure. You said you're going to the Goodwill, right?
Well, how long do you think you'll be here?
Not very long. I'm just making sure I'm seeing everything.
Okay. So when I go to Goodwill, I'll drop you off at Toys R Us. How's that?
Okay, that's fine. Thank you.
I'll just be out in the car.
Alright. Nerf Maverick. I think it's... No, Slip Longshot. My bad. I used to be big into Nerf, but I lost interest a long time ago. Alrighty, finally getting into the Transformers area. Let's see what they got. It's Scoop. Shredderwing. Nice. Got Beast Wars, Transmetal. A Walmart exclusive. Rat Trap. Cool. Here's the back. Sorry about the glare. I'm not a big fan of that either. No one is. No one should be a fan of that. Ooh, here's a nice one. Transmetal Rampage. Ooh, sorry about that. Almost dropped it. I seem to have Butterfingers today, at the time of me filming this video and whatever like that. 99.95, $100, and that's not bad. It's not bad at all. I know what I'm gonna be getting here, but I might as well get a Transformer. I'm going down here. We got one of the aerial bots. What about Will? Something like that. Skywarp with the comic version. Star Wars crossovers. Okay. Energon, Lawnon, Jetfire. Let's see how much this. Fire is my name. Turns into the Blackbird SR-71. Can combine with Revenge of the Fallen Optimus Prime. Let's see, oh, there's the price tag. 150. That's a bit on the high price, but that's fine. Get in there, I want you. Okay. And we got Twin Twist. Some of the Age of Extinction. Soundwave Limited Edition. Beast Wars, Transmetal, Optimus, Optimal Optimus, there we go. Machines, Dark's Night Scream, sorry. 1978 for the price tag, not bad. Oh, actually, okay. At the time I thought, but that was the original game out price right there, doy. These are third party companies. Here's some of these Seco modes. Alright, well, let's see what Galvatron's cost. $29.95. Godly. Alright. I guess I'll be coming around for him once I get back to it. All that they have is a Sentinel Prime for here. Might as well be the same as exact price, yep. Okay, moving the camera over here. Yeah, ball transformers. Sunspot. Third company, Mighty Warriors. Transformers Prime Toys. Classic Universe, Armada. The Boss. 3 mini cons that forms the shield. Unite Warriors. I mean, we feel the shield. My bad. I suck. But TJ Maxx. At that time, it was that price, $10. It went up to $29.95. His Machine Wars, Transformers, Starscream. That's Wheelie. Let's see what this little character's price is. $11.95. Not bad. Is it GoBot case collectible? Yeah, nothing on the back. But you pretty much get the idea. I'm on a hoist. We have this character. Nice tour. Nice package. This is another character I was looking for. But the little GoBots in terms of the Transformers related era. Got a new John Prowl. Getting down here. They got Superpower Doom Man. Here's it. Bumblebee right here. There's never going to be a time when there is too much Bumblebees. 15. That's a bargain. It's one hell of a bargain. Alright, I'm gonna keep looking around. And I forgot to show this off right here. Look at this. One of the Collector's Club figures right here. Armada Blue. And Energon Snowcat. Sweetness. I hope I was able to capture everything. I'm sure you guys were looking at this for whoever that was. It's kind of like X-Bone and the G1 Wheeljack Deco. Deluxe Beast Wars. Cheetor. Heck, a lot of good products here. So, this is what I'm thinking now. I want to leave those be. I know I can come across those at another store. I'm thinking about getting Bumblebee. And Megatron. That's what I'm thinking of getting. So, that's what I'm going to be doing. Unless I can't help myself but to get something else, but I'm not even sure what. We'll find out. We're gonna keep looking around, so let's see what's in the other aisles. We got some Batman stuff. Some DC, Marvel, black figures. Sorry that my camera is shaking. I literally am holding two of those boxes that I said I was gonna purchase. Of the Batman the Animated Series figurines. Batmobile. Thank you. I mean, it's hard to zoom in with one hand. Right. the masterpiece convoys up here. One of them is the first masterpiece and the other one's the newest one, the smallest box. Oh, look at this. Six shot. Let's be this one. Make my purchases and make my way back home. So there we go. Alright everyone, so I came back from Ontario, Ohio, and it was a very successful trip. So let's take a look at, well, what I purchased. So alrighty, before we go on to the Toy Hunters bag haul stuff, there was a Toys R Us nearby, and so I'm just going to show this off just to get out of the way before I actually show off what I actually got from Toy Hunters. Alrighty. So when I got to Toys R Us, I was looking for Starscream, the Warrior exclusive. He's right there, right next to Optimus Prime or something like that, and he wasn't there, but I found one of the figures from that particular wave, and it's pale on, as you can see. So very cool, nice and purple, everything else like that. Let's see if I can turn the package over without dropping it, and that is that. So very cool. So can't wait to, you know, open this up, film a video. Hopefully I can add this to a stop motion in the future and Photoshop this figure to make it look awesome. So that is that figure right there. Now the main haul, two figures, not really a haul, but you know, first one is Bumblebee, the Dark of the Moon Bumblebee. As you saw that I said I was going to purchase it, yes I did. I almost had second thoughts, to be honest, because there was such good figures there at that store. And I'm like, do I really want this? But then it's kind of like, I remember that I bought the Dark of the Moon Bumblebee from Universal Studios, and I bought it. I tried to modify it by taking that racing net off, and I paid the price for it. $39.99, I think, if I remember, was the price tag, and I screwed up, so I deserve to be made fun of at that. So I have a second chance of getting the figure. I'm not gonna do that stupid modding again, because the racing net, stock car net, blends in with the black, so it's all cool, all good, or something like that. So that's the price tag there, 15. So very nice. I can't wait to open this up and do what I always do with all my figures, like I talked about with Pamelon. Alrighty, so last but not least, best for last, another saying for the last, is Titans Return, aka Hidden Masters toy line for Hasbro, Galatron, the Voyager class. So very nice. Oh, you can see my reflection. Hello. So very cool, very nice packaging. Yes, indeed. So that's pretty much the video haul of the day that I was able to go to Ontario and check out the Toy Hunters store. I would have never found out that store if they never posted on Facebook. And that's the thing. They also gave me a flyer. Oh, she did. The lady behind the counter. Very nice, I had a good talk with her. Alright, here's the Fire Haven one. So, Toy Hunters. And that's the owner, operator, Facebook. Make sure you guys follow them and see what's going on in terms of updates and everything else. There's their phone number and their website in yahoo.com. So that is the flyer. So that is that. So thanks again for Toy Hunters for posting out on Facebook. I was happy to come by and check out your store. You have an excellent store. Keep up the good work. And I wish you guys, the team of Toy Hunters, the best in the future. And who knows, maybe I might come by next time. It really depends on what I'm up to in life. But I'll certainly keep you guys in mind forever. And I'm just really happy that I was able to get a couple things and support you. So, very nice. Anyone that lives in Ohio, north, south, middle, around Columbus, make sure you guys check out Ontario. It says Mansfield, but they moved to Ontario. I'm not sure they're going to stay there. I'm not really sure because, you know, I don't know what's everything that's going on. But they were there. So, Ontario, Ohio, make sure you check it out. And happy hunting, everyone.